The answer is 7. Jack-o'-lanterns, chicken of the woods, smooth and common chanterelles, honey and ringless honey mushrooms, plus some waxy caps. These 7 mushrooms do not always look alike. But the jack-o'-lantern, the only toxic mushroom in this list, can resemble the rest 6 non-toxic species at its different stages of development. Enough to fool starters. That is a patch of jack-o'-lantern. From afar, it looks just like the chicken of the woods, or Laetiporus, sulphureus, to be specific, which is also orangish in color. But the tale is, the chicken of the woods belongs to the polypore family, thus the undersurface of the cap has numerous tiny pores, whereas the jack-o'-lantern, like a typical toadstool, has gills. Then, we have this guy, very vibrant colored, can be confused for the jack-o'-lantern at the first glance. It is a waxy cap mushroom, probably the crimson waxy cap. Now, the way to differentiate the two is that, first, check the gills. The jack-o'-lantern has closely spaced, decurrent gills, meaning that the gills are running down the stem. In contrast, the waxy cap have relatively widely spaced gills that are attached to the stem. Second, the crimson waxy cap is relatively small and flimsy, and as its name indicates, the cap is waxy or slimy. But the jack-o'-lantern has dry, smooth caps. Okay, ready for the real lookalikes of the jack-o'-lantern? Right, chanterelles. Both the smooth and common chanterelles can look like the jack-o'-lantern. Smooth chanterelles resemble mature jack-o'-lanterns, as both tend to have very wavy margins, and their caps can be more or less depressed or funnel-shaped. Yet again, the tail is the undersurface of the cap. See how smooth the undercap of a smooth chanterelle is? These shallow wrinkles can hardly be confused with the true gills of a jack-o'-lantern. But the common chanterelle can be much trickier. Although common chanterelles have what we call false gills, or ridges, which are much shallower and blunter than true gills. It's not always easy to tell the jack-o'-lantern apart from chanterelles with more developed ridges, especially considering that both the true gills on the left-hand side and the ridges on the right-hand side are decurrent. So here's the key. When identifying mushrooms, don't only focus on individual specimens. Instead, you need to get the big picture, aka how and where the mushrooms grow. These are chanterelles. See, they are scattered and gregarious. You may find 2 or 3 growing together, but that's about it. You probably won't find anything larger than that. The other thing is, they often grow on the ground. although occasionally you can spot some next to tree stumps.
These are chicolinda mushrooms. They have very bright...
Now, see for yourself the habitat and the structure of jack-o'-lanterns.
Some jack-o'-lantern here.
They always grow on stumps, or on some buried roots, meaning that they don't just pop up on grass or forest floors. In addition, they grow in pretty big clusters. Real clusters with their roots connected. By now, we've covered four characteristics of the jack-o'-lantern: the orange or sometimes brownish color, decurrent gills growing on tree stumps, and in large clusters. But what if there are some species out there that possess almost all the same features? Now, check these out. They are the honey and the ringless honey mushrooms. When they are young and are yet to fully reveal their features, these three species are especially confusing. One thing you can easily tell is that both honeys and ringless honeys have yellowish caps, whereas jack-o'-lanterns have orangish caps. But never identify a mushroom only by its cap color. There are more to check. The honey mushroom has a partial bill that protects the gills when it's young and forms a ring when the mushroom matures.
Jack-o'-lantern versus honey. Young jack-o'-lantern versus young.
But there's no ring on the stem of the jack-o'-lantern.
Compare their individual ones. See, young honey has a veil, but jack-o'-lantern doesn't have.
Well, the main difference is the color.
Yet there are ringless honeys too. They also grow on tree stumps and in big clusters, and have decurrent gills.
So these are very young specimens of jack-o'-lantern.
But see, jack-o'-lanterns have orange caps, orange flesh, orange gills, light orange stems, whereas ringless honeys have pale brownish yellow caps, whitish gills, and brownish stems that are whitish on top and get much darker toward the bottom. Besides, if you look closely enough, the honeys and ringless honeys have dark hairs on their caps and stems. And both produce stark white spore prints, but the spore print of the jack-o'-lantern is yellowish. Okay, now you should be able to properly identify these seven mushrooms. It's October now, so you probably won't see many smooth and common chanterelles, as well as the waxy cap. But the jack-o'-lantern, chicken, and honeys should be flourishing out there. So go out and look for them. Good luck!